I want to switch gears now, and the number of the week, an interesting conversation. Now, let me just give you a little bit of background and context to this. Now, there's a Global Peace Index that is ranks about 100, actually more than 160 countries around the world. It's done by a think tank known as the Institute for Economics and Peace. It's now in its 10th year, and they've released their Global Peace Index 2016. Now, they're saying that the world has become more dangerous in 2016, and from the previous board, you could see that only 10 countries in the world are said to be completely free from conflict. Now, just two are African countries, and let's take this number a little bit cautiously, because one of them that is in the top 10 is Botswana, the other is Mauritius, you know, an island off the Indian Ocean coast. We like to lump it together as Africa. So only two countries are said to be the most peaceful. Now, let me just round off the top 10 for you real quick. Botswana, Chile, Costa Rica, Japan, Mauritius, Panama, Qatar, Switzerland, Uruguay, and Vietnam. Now, I know you want to know what Kenya's ranking is. We're not doing too well in this ranking. 131 out of 163. Now, regionally, are we doing well? Excuse me? No, we're not. In fact, Tanzania is doing better than us. They're ranked 58 out of 163. Even Uganda is doing better than us, 101. Out of 63. Now, this Global Peace Index, you may ask, why is this important and does it even matter? Well, it's an interesting thing pointing at where government funding goes to. Now, in countries that are less peaceful than others, it means they're spending more money on creating and containing conflict. What does this mean? It means then that there is less money for development issues. Such as poverty, health, and education. If we're a country that's spending a little bit more on creating and containing conflict, and by the way, they take a look at a number of issues, including domestic and international conflict. And one of the big things that they're looking at is, or the big threats to peace in the world, is terrorism and political instability. So you can imagine a number of countries in Africa, like Burundi, and also, abroad like Syria. In fact, the Middle East and Africa are said to be contributing heavily to the deterioration of peace in the country. Now, this is so important that the UN is now recognizing peace as an important atmosphere for development, which is why it is one of those sustainable development goals, number 16, that takes a look at peace, justice, and strong institutions. And of course, this Global Peace Index has been endorsed by a number of world leaders, Kofi Annan, the Dalai Lama, among several others. So Kenya, 131 out of 163. Also important to note, by the way, is that there's a peace inequality gap. Apparently, those that are less violent are, you know, continuing to improve, while those that are less peaceful are continuing to deteriorate. So there's this huge gap in the world, and Kenya is falling not very well there. In fact, Somalia is 159 out of 163. So you can see Kenya not doing too well. That is your number for the week. So go out and make peace. We're taking a short break right now. We'll be back with the day's sports.